गुड मॉर्निंग, अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश बाल भारती क्लास 4. इन आवर इंग्लिश बाल भारती टेक्स्ट बुक वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू चैप्टर. चैप्टर नेम इज The dreadful guest. Now, what is the meaning of dreadful? Dreadful means fearful. So, when a fearful guest comes suddenly in your house or to visit you, what happens? Now, I will read the lesson and explain to you about this story of The dreadful guest. Now all of you listen carefully and pay attention. Okay, let's start our lesson. Lesson number 27, The dreadful guest. Once upon a time, the king of Russia decided to hold a grand feast. He invited prince, rich merchants, brave warriors, and all the important people in his kingdom. On the night of the feast, the king and his guest sat together at a long table in the banquet hall. They talked and laughed, and everyone was happy. Now here in this paragraph, we come to know that once the king of Russia, now we have a country, India, same like this way, Russia also a country. And the king over there decided to hold a grand feast. What is mean by feast? Feast means a large meal for many people on a particular or a special occasion. So he invited prince, rich merchants, brave warriors, and all the important people from his kingdom. And all that night, the feast, king, guest, they all are set together on the banquet table. Banquet means what? Where the grand celebration was held. They were laugh, talk each other, enjoying themselves. Everyone was very happy and they are enjoying their feast. Let's see the next passage from this story. Suddenly, a huge animal burst into the hall. It was a horrible looking dragon. It was as tall as a tree, as broad as a house, with teeth spiked, claws like knives. His skin was hard and scaly, and his eyes red. Red hot flames shot forth from his mouth, and black smoke from his nostrils. Now the dragon was also a very mean creature. He loved to be a spoiled sport and a killjoy. He walked straight to the head of the table and pushed everyone to stop talking. Everyone was scared. Well, not everyone. The brave warrior Ivan was not afraid of dragon. "What a rude, impolite creature you are," he said angrily. Now here in this paragraph, tell us the huge horrible dragon. Dragon means a large monster burst into the hall. It means he entered in the hall suddenly, and it was look like a tall as a tree, as broad as a house, with teeth like a spike. Now spike means a narrow thin shape with sharp pointed at one end clouds like knives. Clouds means sharp thin curve nail on a finger or a toes of the animal or a bird. With hard and scaly skin, scaly means covered with the scales. His red eyes and hot flames shot forth from his mouth and black smoke from his nostril. The dragon was very rude creature. He loved to be spoil sport. Spoil sport means what? Means a person who spoil others' enjoyment and kill joy. They disturb to others and they are enjoying to do this. This paragraph. Now next one says that when suddenly the dragon enter into the banquet hall, there is all are fear. They are all are scared to see what going to happen here. Now rude means dragon was go straight to the table and push himself between the king and the queen. Everyone stop talking. They are scared. The brave warrior is there. Ivan was not afraid from the dragon. And he said angrily to the dragon, what he said that? He said, what a rude, impolite creature you are. It means the dragon. He said, Ivan said to angrily to the dragon, what a rude, impolite creature you are. Now next one, let's see what is the happen in the next passage. Just then the servants brought in the food and set the platters on the table. But before they had a chance to serve the food to the king and the queen and the guests, the dragon began to gobble up everything. The king and the queen did not know what to do. Nobody could stop the dragon. But Ivan spoke up again. Nobody has ever taught you any manners, I can see, he said. I hope you choke on the food you are gobbling up so greedily. Now here, when the servants brought in the food and set the platters, platters means the large plate serving dish used to serve the food before. They could serve the food. Before they could serve the food, dragon began to gobble. Gobble means eat hurriedly and noisily. The king and the queen did not know what to do because suddenly the dragon entered into the hall. The king and the queen, they also did not know what to do. No one can stop the dragon, but the brave warriors is sat on the that table. Who was he? He was Ivan. Ivan asked him again, nobody taught you any manners, and said to hope the dragon choke on the food. It was eating so greedily. Choke means food gets stuck. He follow it very hurriedly. He is eating all the food fastly, speedily, and spoil all the food on the table. See the next passage. Now, this was more than the dragon could stand. He puffed out fire and sprang to his feet. I dare you to come out and fight with me, Ivan, he roared. Are you ready? Of course, said Ivan. So here in this paragraph we come to know that the dragon could not take up this insult and puff out his fire. Puff means start amount of air or a smoke blow out and sprang means jump up suddenly and to Ivan's feet and said to fight with him. Ivan also agreed, but king said to him, let's put up with dragon. Put up means adjust with dragon, otherwise dragon will burn or kill him more time. Now here the dragon challenged to the Ivan, and Ivan also accepted his challenge to fight with him. Now what are you done, Ivan, said the king. Let's put up with the dragon for some more time. You cannot fight a dragon. It will burn or kill you more time. Now here the king said that, what are you doing? What are you done, Ivan? Don't put up it. You have to adjust with the dragon. Otherwise, he will kill you or burn you more time. You have to adjust with the dragon. See the next one. But Ivan was not afraid. He knew that the dragons were dreadful but not intelligent. He was sure he could find a way killing the dragon. Now what happened here? When the Ivan was not afraid of dragon because he knew that dragon are dreadful but not a intelligent. They don't have brain. So dreadful means fearful, and Ivan was sure that he could find a way of killing the dragon. He could find the exact proper way to kill the dragon. He was confident about it. Why? Because he know that the dragons are only dreadful, not they are intelligent. See the next paragraph. Everyone walk out to the palace courtyard. The dragon and the brave warrior face each other. The dragon smile a very mean and big smile. Now, how shall I kill you, you silly fool? He asked Ivan. Shall I burn you to death? Shall I smother you with worms? Or better still, shall I tear you up with my knife claws? Or shall I eat up with my spike teeth? Now here the Ivan accepted the challenge to defeat and fight with the dragon. And everyone went to the palace courtyard. The dragon and Ivan face each other. The dragon asked to the Ivan, how should I kill you? Shall I burn you or smother with my thumbs? Thumbs means small flaming gas. Or eat you with my pointed teeth, spike, dangerous pointed teeth. He asked to the Ivan. See the next one. In the meanwhile, however, the clever Ivan had thought of a way of tricking the big creature. He folded his arm on his chest and said in a clear voice, now, look here, dragon, when you dare me to fight you, I agreed readily. I thought it would be a fight between just the two of us. Then he pointed behind the dragon. Why you brought a whole army to help you fight? The dragon was stupid. As Ivan thought him to be, turned his head to see what Ivan was pointing at. Quick as flash of lightning, Ivan drew his sword and cut off the dragon's head. There he said, "We won't have to put up with this dreadful guest ever again." Now, what happened here, dear students? Here in this paragraph, we understand while the dragon asked Ivan how he should kill him, Ivan kept thinking of plan, and because he knew dragons are dreadful but not intelligent, so he decided to trick to the weak creature. Here Ivan planned a trick for this weak creature. He pointed behind the dragon and asked him why he had brought a whole army to fight when it was supposed to fight only between two of them. As soon as a dragon turned his head, then to see of which army. So Ivan was talking about, he drew and out his sword and cut the dragon's head. Then Ivan's soul, "We won't have a just put a such dreadful guest ever again. We won't have just this like this a dangerous or put up this dreadful guest ever again." I hope you understood this lesson very well. Enjoy the watching video, understood the story of the dreadful guest. Thank you.